So, in the early 20th century, traces of a new civilization were discovered in India, the Indus Valley Civilization, also called the Harappan Civilization. This new discovery changed the origin of Indian history. This was a river valley civilization built along the river Indus, just like the Mesopotamian, Egyptian, and the Chinese civilizations. This civilization is believed to have first began in 2600 BCE. And as it seems, it was the largest and the most advanced civilization of the time. Now, let me first show you a map to show you how large this civilization actually was. As you can see, it occupied large parts of present-day Pakistan and Northwest India. This was way larger than Egypt and Mesopotamia and just a bit larger than the Shang dynasty in China as well, at 1.3 million square kilometers. This wasn't actually the world's oldest civilization, that title belongs to Mesopotamia, but this was the world's first urban civilization. Now, as you can probably derive from the name, Harappa in present-day Pakistan was the largest city in this civilization, followed by Mohenjo-daro, Chanu-daro, Lothal, and Kalibangan. Some historians first believed that the Harappan civilization was of a foreign origin. They believed that a large number of Mesopotamians had migrated here and built the civilization. But as it stands, this civilization was of indigenous origin and not of foreign origin, because very little similarities have been discovered between the Harappan and the other civilizations. For example, Harappan cities followed a grid pattern with roads running north to south or east to west, while Mesopotamian cities followed a circular pattern built around the temple. So now that that's settled, I can safely say that the Harappan cities were extremely elaborately planned. The Harappan cities were divided into two parts, the raised area and the lower area. So the raised area was called the citadel and the lower area was called the lower town. So basically, the citadel had important buildings like the Great Bath, the Granary, the Assembly Hall, and other important buildings, while the lower town had residential buildings where people lived and worked. I said earlier that the roads followed a grid pattern. Thus, the city was divided by those roads into rectangular blocks. Also, the houses near the corners were rounded so that the carts could pass easily. The drainage system was very well thought out too. All the wastewater was emptied into the street drains from the house drains. But how do we know about this civilization? Well, written records are out of the question, as they are either unavailable or incomprehensible. So we will see the archaeological remains, which give us all the knowledge we have about the Harappan civilization. First is the Great Bath. It's a big pool of water which was watertight. Yeah, that's basically it. So, as you can probably tell, the construction of the Great Bath symbolizes that the level of construction during the Harappan civilization had reached a great degree of perfection. Also, we can also imply that the leaders collected taxes from the people and also could mobilize labor to build such massive structures, and that there was also very good planning when it came to the structural features of the Great Bath related to water supply and sewage disposal. Next, we have the citadel. Remember? This tells us that the Harappan civilization was an urban civilization and that the cities were extremely elaborately planned. About 2000 different seals have been discovered as well. No, not this seal, these seals. Some seals tell us about the gods that the people believed in, while some tell us about how the Harappan trail was spread over a vast area. Other than that, we have the bearded man, the dancing girl, both of which show us the skills of the artisans, and a dockyard in Lothal, located near the coast. A lot of overseas trade took place from there. We also have the script, which is regarded as pictographic, as its signs represent birds and fishes. The Harappan civilization is said to have declined around 1800 BCE. Historians have come up with many theories as to how this civilization might have ended. Four of them are the most likely causes for the decline of this civilization. The first cause is floods and earthquakes. A devastating flood combined with an earthquake must have raised the water level very much. This might have led to the upliftment of floodplains to a very large extent, such that the river wasn't able to pass into the sea. This might have caused water to accumulate and flood the land so much that the settlement had to be abandoned. The streets of Mohenjo-daro were found covered with silty clay left by floodplains. The second cause is simply increased aridity. Some of the tributaries of the river Indus must have changed course, leading to the drying up of the land and the abandonment of the settlement due to the absence of an ample supply of water. The third cause is deforestation. Some believe that due to the need of enormous quantities of wood, deforestation must have occurred on a very large scale, leading to climate change in the region. The fourth cause, which is probably the most likely, is attack. The Aryans who built the Vedic civilization after the end of the Harappan civilization are believed to have attacked the Indus settlements and destroyed them. There is also evidence that men, women, and children were massacred due to the presence of skeletons of 13 males and females and one child lying in a room. So, which reason do you think is the most likely for the decline of the Harappan civilization? Tell me in the comments. So, I hope you liked this video. Please do hit the like button and also don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.